I decided I'd tell you one of my stories that directly relates to this. I don't have the stamina, the will, or the patience to write a short story. So I write things called tiny tales. They're not like, you know, pithy, but they're not short stories. So this one is called She Talked Unto Herself. So this is about Callie and Beanie. And Callie and Beanie were two really young girls who lived in Virginia. Callie was the little white girl, and Beanie was the little slave girl. And they grew up together, so they played with each other all the time. It was always known, though, that they weren't equal, because Callie slept in the bed, and Beanie slept at her feet, especially if it got really cold to keep her feet warm. They always had a great time. They were just like sisters from another mother. But as Callie grew older, she still saw Beanie as her bestest until her friends started to come to the house. She started to treat Beanie differently. In the beginning, it was just like, no, you can't play with us or you can't eat with us. Then it became little words and salutations that talked about where she really was and what she really was. That her hair wasn't really straight enough, and maybe it's dusty, and yeah, you're really not dressed the way we are, and you can't play with us, and Beanie was very hurt. Well, that real night happened when Callie had her friends over, and they were all sitting around having tea. You know who was serving tea. By this time, Callie was a young girl in Virginia, and Beanie was not only her slave, she was her seamstress. Callie was going off to this great show, and because Beanie was such an amazing seamstress, she always asked her friends to come over. Come on over and see what Beanie's making. Look at the embroidery. Look how she's such a beautiful. And Beanie showing her the dress just made a mistake and pricked her with a pin. And Callie hit her and called her a nigger. Wait a second. We used to play together and we'd break a cookie and eat it, and I never cared and you never cared. And all the women were laughing. Beanie was hurt in a special place. See, there are, you know, special compartments we have inside ourselves. And some people can say stuff and you don't get that upset, or you figure out how to work this out, but Callie said something that so deeply harmed her, she didn't know she could come back. So she devised a plan. She heard all them old women talking about how there were poisons in your roots. This and that, and the ants be outside.
Well.
So she found a plan, and she had to be really careful. And she would drag the thread through the plant. And as she was stitching the neckline and the sleeves, she deposited just enough to make Callie sick. So Callie went to the dance, you know, she met with everybody, the garment was beautiful. Beanie made special little flowers for her hair and decorated her gloves. And when she came home that night, she had a fever. And by the next day, she was almost dead. And of course, Beanie could not control herself because she didn't want to kill her. She just wanted to teach her a lesson. She helped to nurse Callie back. And Callie was her friend again, of course, because she was nursing her and bringing her tea and wiping her brow and telling her stories about when they were younger and the new dresses she was going to make. And as soon as Callie really got better and her friends came back, things changed again. Well, Beanie knew she could not take that step again. So you know what she did? Got all the little girls together and started to teach them how to sew.
Mm-hmm.
Change is gone.